Good morning, everyone. We're continuing in the halachot for now regarding blessings. He writes like this, Nikud Yosef. The way you should recite blessings is the way he says you count money. Very slowly. It's all money. Don't swallow the words, rather you should emit the words from your mouth. Not only the word, but don't even swallow letters. A lot of times you'll see in Shema, some Siddurim have stars at the end of a word and the beginning of the word, because they both end with and start with the same letter, like mem, right? Ubechol levavcha, right? It also has two lamets. So some people, they swallow it, ubechol levavcha, they make it one phrase. He says, even letters, you have to make sure you separate. From this he says, you know, you see rebuke to people that they bless quickly and they swallow. Then motzina tevot kilchatan. He says they end up instead of saying brochat Hashem. What they say buchta dunai eleni macha olam. Right, they end up swallowing words. That's what he writes. Velo dai sheneni min haolam hazeh belo bracha. Not only are they enjoying from this world without reciting blessings, shechot, because we have a rule. Any bracha they don't say lukenu melech haolam is not a blessing. You have to mention Shem u'malchut. You have to mention God's name and also His kingdom. Not only that, but he writes, it's not an honorable thing to speak in front of God mumbling, because you would never do such thing in front of a regular king. A king would take your head off if you would talk to him like that. In front of a king of flesh and blood, you speak with fear, with awe. How much more so to God? And woe to that embarrassment, to the person that mumbles when he blesses. Ba'an Ken, therefore he says, Yesh li'zaer, b'shash mevarech o'mitpalel, whenever a person prays or recites blessings, you should be careful. She'otzia tevot kilchatan, v'yavin perush ha'milot lefachot. At minimum, you should understand the translation of the words and recite it properly. V'shalton al kol davar argel. He says, with a little practice, things become habit. V'ashomea tavo alab berkat tov, right? And he brings down from Rav Yehuda Tzadka again that Rav Yehuda Tzadka gave advice to people, you could split the blessing into three parts. You say, Baruch Atah Hashem, stop. Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, stop. It's like that, each time you force yourself, obviously don't do for a minute break, but those 2 seconds, you force yourself to have Kavanah in the words that you're saying. And last time, he writes like this, K'tiv, it says in the Pasuk in Tehillim, Baruchi Nafshi Et Hashem, my soul blesses God, all my inner organs, they bless Hashem's name. Mikan, from here the Chachamim learn, when you bless God, you have to do it, you have to do it with all your organs. Because Sefer Chasidim writes, when you speak out loud, all your organs have to work together to remove the voice up to the throat. So that's in what David HaMelech is saying, you have to be blessing God out loud. And likewise, it's just good advice. When you recite blessings out loud, it forces you to say it correctly because you're going to hear yourself mumbling. That's why if you notice, a lot of people, when they pray quietly, they don't know they're making mistakes until they become chazanim. When they become chazanim, then they realize, wait a minute, I swallowed this way. Because they have to force themselves to hear how they pray now. That's why a lot of them praying out loud will help you in kavanah. It's one of the methods they give to have more kavanah. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen.